Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, we'll be discussing about Sprite Atlas in Unity. So let's look at the example. Before starting the tutorial, we need to have a folder of sprites. Now I have the objects folder inside my assets folder, which has some of the sprites. Okay, so you can have your sprites in that folder. Now according to Unity documentation, whenever you drag and drop this image onto the scene, the Unity engine generates a draw call. The more the amount of draw call, the more the performance degradation. Unity has given you something called a Sprite Atlas. Now the Sprite Atlas combines all the sprites that you use in your scene and uses fewer amount of draw calls in order to render those into your scene. So the way to create a Sprite Atlas is by right clicking here, create and Sprite Atlas. I'll name it Sprite Atlas. You can see here a field has appeared that is objects for packing. So this is basically asking you for a folder of sprites that you need to insert or you need to drag into this slot. So I already have this objects folder here. I'll simply click on it and drag and drop it onto this slot. Now I have all my sprites combined into one Sprite Atlas. Now in order to see the Sprite Atlas in action, what I'll do is I'll right click here and create a sprite. Now to this sprite we will attach a script. This sprite, we will use this sprite in order to render the image from the Sprite Atlas. So we first create a script, right click and create C# script. I'll name it Test Sprite Atlas. I'll assign it to the sprite that I have created on the scene. I'll change the name of it to Test Sprite and open the script in Visual Studio. So here the first thing that I do is I'll declare an enum type that is of sprite type. And it will contain all the names of the sprites. I have kept the name of the sprites similar to the name that we have in the folder. So now basically these are all numbered from 0. Next, I'll create a private variable, private sprite type, and I'll name it current selected. On top of this variable, I'll write serialize field. I'll say it and go back to Unity Editor. Now if you see the test sprite variable, you'll see that now we have a little dropdown of the enum types that we had declared. So here we can make a selection and get that selection in this private variable. Now I'll quickly demonstrate to you how we use the Sprite Atlas to render the image at runtime. So the first thing that I'll do is I'll declare a variable of type sprite renderer. I'll name it myRenderer. Now inside the start method, I'll write myRenderer is equal to getComponent. I'll get a reference to the sprite renderer. So I have got a reference to the sprite renderer of my Unity game. Now the next thing that I do is I declare a variable of type sprite atlas and I'll declare it with a serialized field so that I can access it in Unity. Now here you have the slot for the sprite atlas. So what I'll do is I'll just drag and drop this sprite atlas component onto this slot. Now I can make use of the Sprite Atlas in my code. So here what I'll write is myRenderer.sprite is equal to atlas.getSprite and let's see which sprite do I want on the scene. So I have decided to draw this extreme sprite onto the scene. So I'll write extreme, save it, go back to Unity. Now we'll run this scene. Here we see that our extreme sprite, that is the wheel, has rendered itself and we did the rendering at runtime. But we have declared a variable named currentSelected that we haven't used right now. So I need to use this currentSelected. So the way to do this is by removing this static calling of the sprite. So I'll declare a function here and its type will be private. So private void change sprite type. Inside this function we have to compare the currently selected sprite and the last selected sprite. So I'll write if current selected. Now I need to declare a variable that holds my last selected sprite. So I'll write in the beginning private sprite type last selected. So if current selected is not equal to the last selected, so I know that my current selection and the last selections are different. So in that case what I'll do is I'll call the renderer myRenderer.sprite is equal to atlas.getSprite and inside the braces I'll write current selected dot toString. That is, I'm passing in the string of the sprite name inside this getSprite method. So the name of the sprite that is currently selected is assigned to the sprite property. And after rendering the sprite, what we'll do is we'll assign the currently selected sprite to the last sprite. So last selected is equal to current selected. We need to call this function. We'll call this inside the update method. So I'll write here change sprite type. Now I need to have a beginning value for the last selected because it is making a comparison with the last selected. So what I'll do is I'll make a static assignment to the last selected variable. So I'll write last selected is equal to sprite type dot, I assign it little small. So coming back to the Unity game, if I run it, you'll see that the small is being selected. Next, medium. So it will come to this car body, little small, little big. This is how you dynamically generate the sprites at runtime. And this is how Sprite Atlas works. It makes minimum amount of draw calls in order to draw the sprites onto your scene. And this leads to performance optimization of your Unity game. So I hope you understood about the Sprite Atlas.